Hello everyone, I hope you are doing great and you have been learning pandas. I hope this session is useful. In this session, we are going to learn about filters. So far we have learned how to do data cleaning and how you can read the data and how you can output the data in Excel file. So in this session, I'm going to tell you all about filters. What is the kind of filters which you can apply? What is the conditional filter? What is the logical filter which you can apply? So let's see the data set again. This is a data set which we have, which is talking about all the different types of foods which is available in India and what is the ingredients required to cook them and how much is the preparation time and cook time. Okay, so this is the data set which we have been working on. Now let's say let's apply our first filter on the name of the columns. Okay, now let's say we don't want to have all the columns, we just want to have a name of the food and we want to know about the cook time for that food. Okay, so in that case we can use df.filter and we need to use parentheses, and inside this we need to provide list of all the columns which we want to select. So let's say if I just want to have name and I want to have cook time, so I just need to provide both of these column names, and I'm going to run it now, and now you can see we are able to see just the name and the cook time. Okay, so this is how you can filter one or multiple columns in a data frame. Now let's move ahead, and let's say we want to now filter based on certain value in a column. Okay, so notice one thing, we have just applied the filter but we have not changed the actual data frame. Okay, so in the next cell, if I just type df and run it, we are still going to see all the columns. Okay, so if you just want to update data frame with this applied filter, in that case you can do df equal to and you can run it. Okay, so I'm not going to run it, I just want to show you. So I'm just going to delete it and going to move on to next cell. Okay, so in this cell now, let's say we want to see only the food name, which is bundi and ghevar. Okay, so these are the very famous desserts, sweets, okay, which is being very popularly used in India. Okay, so now I'm going to filter based on a column value. So I'm going to say let's see only the name, which is equal to either, so let's first see which is equal to bundi. Okay, so let's see, let's say you just want to filter only, you know, record which is having name of bundi. Okay, so this is how we actually apply filter. But if you run it, and it is just going to give you value of true or false. So let's run it, and now you see what it is returning is actually a series which is telling you that all the other, you know, values are false and only one cell is true. Okay, so now what we need to do is we need to write df, and in the square brackets we need to keep all these condition, filter condition which we have just written. So now if I run it, you are going to see we are going to get the record. Okay, so this is the record which is having name as bundi. Okay, so now you know how you can filter any value from any column. Okay, so now let's say you want to now filter based on two values. Okay, so here I'm going to write df again, and let's say we want to filter based on bundi and ghevar. Okay, so I want to filter two records. So how we are going to do it? So it is also very simple. All you need to do is you need to say name equal to bundi, and then you need to write same condition again, and in between you need to use OR operator. Okay, so we are saying name can be either bundi or name can be either ghevar. Okay, now what do you think is going to happen when I run it? Okay, so let's say if I run it, in that case I'm going to get some error. Okay, so this is what is happening if I run it like this. So what exactly we need to do here is we need to keep this condition in parentheses. Okay, because I'll tell you the reason, but let's just first put these conditions inside parentheses. Okay, and we need to separate it with this OR operator. Okay, so now I'm going to run it, and now you can see we are getting the series again, which is telling us true and false values. Okay, and as usual, as we did previously, we are going to keep this in square brackets and going to give the name of data frame here, which is df. Okay, now I'm going to run it, and now you can see we have Bundi and Gaber, only two records filtered out, and rest all records have been gone. We can just see now two records. Okay, so now let me tell you why we use parentheses here. So the reason to use parentheses here is that this OR operator is having more weightage. Okay, so if we don't use this, you know, parentheses, in that case what is happening is this is going to be operated something like this. Okay, so I'm just going to remove this parentheses and going to show you if we don't use parentheses, that then what happens is that, you know, pandas interprets is something like this. Okay, so it is going to see Bundi or df name. Okay, and this is how basically it is going to get interpreted, and it results in error. So whenever you are applying OR operator, you need to make sure all the conditions are inside parentheses. Okay, obviously you can add more filters. So for example, let's say we also want to see a record which is having value of I'm just gonna pick this one, Shufta. I don't know what this is, I have never written this, but let's just apply one more filter. And I'm going to select this, going to apply OR operator, and here we are going to change it to this value. I'm just going to copy from here and going to paste it here. Okay, and once I run it, now we see we have three records. So this is how you can filter out records. Now let's say we want to apply we want to apply on multiple columns. We don't want to apply filter on single column. So let's say I want to see, let's take a record where name is equal to Bundi, or let's take any dish, okay, which is from state Punjab. Okay, so in that case we can make it like, I'm just going to leave it as it is, and we are going to apply new filter here. So in that case we are going to say df where name is equal to Bundi, this one, and then we are going to use, of course, we are going to surround it with parentheses, and we are going to use OR operator. We are going to say now where state is equal to Punjab. Okay, and also we need to surround it with parentheses. And now if I run it, it's just giving me true and false again. So just, you need to keep df and you need to keep everything inside square brackets. Run it, and now you can see, you see Bundi, even though Bundi is not from Punjab, and then you see all the foods which is from Punjab. Okay, so now you know how you can apply filters and OR condition based on multiple columns or different, you know, types of columns. Now what we are going to do is we are going to apply OR condition. Okay, oh sorry, we are going to apply AND condition. Okay, so what we are going to say is we want to see all the food where preparation time is less than 20 and cook time is also less than 20. Okay, so I'm just going to change the, or let's apply new filter and let's remove it, and we are going to say df, and I'm going to say where prep time is less than 20, and we need to say cook time is also less than 20. Okay, so first thing is I'm just going to keep it in parentheses, and then we are going to use AND operator. So AND operator is by using this symbol ampersand. Okay, so inside this you will say df cook time is also less than 20. Okay, so this is how you write AND operator. So it is going to show us only the records where preparation time and cook time both are less than 20. Okay, so let's also put df and put all these condition in square brackets, and now let's run it. And now we can see all the records are gone. We are only having the records where preparation time and cook time is less than 20. Okay, you can again make it less than 10 just to see even less number of records. Okay, so now you see we are having all the foods where preparation time and cook time is less than 5. I'm sorry, less than 10. Okay, so this is how you apply AND operator, and also you apply OR operator. Now let's say we want to see all the foods which is in the list. Okay, so it is more like a SQL IN operator. Okay, so we are going to see how we can perform that. Before that, I'm just going to run df here again, and let's say we want to see all the food which is in one of the list. Okay, so let me prepare the list. I'm going to say food names equal to, let's say we are saying Gaber and we are saying Pinaka, and also we are going to take one more, which is, let's take Shufta. Okay, so now or it can go on and on. Okay, so we can in fact have Bundi and many others. Okay, now let's say I want to have only the records which are having one of these values, okay, in the name. In that case, what I can do is I can say df, and we need to use the column name, which is name, and we are going to use is in function. Okay, so we are going to see is in, and here in the function we need to pass this complete list. Okay, so now the list is in food names. So this is how we are going to pass it, and if I run it now, it's going to return true and false as usual. And I'm just going to now keep everything in df square brackets, and I'm going to run it. Now you can see we are having only the names which is in this list. Okay, and now let's say you want to see everything, but you don't want to see the values which is in the list. Okay, so in that case you can simply negate it by using this negate operator. Okay, and just notice the syntax here. We just need to prefix this negate operator, and then we are going to run it again. Now we are going to see all the food names which is not in this list. Okay, so this is very useful operator, and this is very similar to SQL query where you use SQL not in operator, okay, or in operator. So we have a function is in which can be used for this purpose. Okay, so in terms of filter, that's all we have in the filters. So I guess we have already covered all sorts of filters which can be used, and also I showed you how you can use these filters, and you can combine them to get the result which you want. Now if you have been liking these sessions, then please subscribe the channel and also like the video, and also do not forget to give your valuable comments. If you want me to explain some topic in more detail, or if you want me to explain some topic in at certain pace, then please let me know in the comment section. I'll be more than happy to follow the feedback. Okay, so thank you so much for watching. See you again in the next session.